I got a lot of requests to try more games on the Steam Deck, so here we are. This time I'm gonna run all the games without DC power, so we can see the power drain, and I'm gonna try a few games with the 30 FPS limiter on as well. Let's start with Fallout 4. Now the graphics options are only configurable in the launcher, which is kind of awkward because you have to use the touchscreen, and you can't change these things inside the game, so I just selected the high quality preset. Here are all the settings. And from what I could tell, it runs pretty smoothly. So here we are in game. Graphics are all on high and ultra, and it's running at like 50 FPS in this region. If we go into a more populated area, it will drop down. But this game is a pretty good example for using the frame limiter. We will limit the frame rate to 30 FPS, and that will pretty much be constant throughout your playtime here. I'm gonna load an older save file where I was in Diamond City to see how that performs. Yeah, pretty smooth. Out of curiosity, we can try disabling the frame limiter. Yeah, 50, almost 60 FPS, pretty good. But it is dropping to 30 sometimes, so having the frame limiter on definitely helps. If you want to have a constant 60, you can try going with the medium preset and the launcher. Next up, let's look at Injustice 2. Similar to Arkham City in my last video, this game states that it's unsupported. However, as you will see, it actually runs pretty well. Now, full disclosure, I'm only trying single player in these games. Maybe the unsupported features are related to the online play. I'm not sure. Here are the graphics settings. I have everything basically maxed out. And I'll run the benchmark first, and you will see it runs at a constant 60 FPS with no issues. Oh. There you go. I'll also do a quick fight just to show it off.
Poison Ivy.
Quick side note, I've never played this game before, so don't expect much from me.
Poison Ivy.
Shouldn't you be at a fundraiser?
Consider this community outreach. Begin.
Now, Cyberpunk is kind of all over the place. You pretty much have to play with the frame limiter because it jumps from 50-60 to 20-30 a lot. So it's better to just have the frame limiter on. And I'm gonna be using the medium quick preset to begin with. And let's see how it goes. Here are all the settings.
Okay.
Yakuza Kiwami 2 runs very nicely with a mix of high and medium settings. If you limit the FPS to 30, you'll get basically the PS4 experience with even higher graphics than it was on that console. I'm gonna start off without the frame limiter. I'll enable the frame limiter now, and actually, I think I can afford to bring up the graphics a bit. Of course, you can't have Yakuza without doing some karaoke. Lastly, let's look at the benchmark for Guardians of the Galaxy. These are the settings I found to be the most balanced. And I'm gonna be running it with the frame limiter on. So you can see the average FPS was 29-30, but it did have a few major drops.
Quill possesses the magical weapons.
I'm getting random frame drops from time to time. Let's see if we can do something about that.
Let's keep pushing forward. Your Quill, I fear I will not be able to harm your child if she is lost.
Of course you wouldn't let him, you big lug, but what if you don't get... Thanks, bud.
Bets on what's down there?
No.
Better than being exposed up here.
Guys, it's not too late to surrender.
Awesome.
Drop your blasters and we'll call it even, okay?
Once again, thanks for watching. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you want to see some more games ran on the Steam Deck and you missed my previous video, check that out. Well, and thank you for 1,000 subs. Yay! Okay, take care, bye!